Hi everyone, Marin here for Land Fun, welcome back. For today's card, I did my favorite thing. I mixed and matched a bunch of sets to create a super cute scene in the countryside. First, here is a behind the scene footage. I often get questions about how I plan my cards, and the answer is pretty simple. About the theme, I always have a quite precise idea in my head. For this card, it was a picnic scene, so I first placed the mice, and then I went through my entire Land Fun collection, looking for stems that could fit the theme, stems that would help me to create a cute scene. Next, I usually decide if I want to make an interactive card or a more simple card. Here I wanted to create a magic iris card, so I die-cut the main panel and I placed all the stems. And here the idea was that we get back to our mice family again, but just the parents. They dropped off the kids at the grandparents and hit the road to go camping in the countryside, just the two of them. This is how I usually work. The main theme, interactive card or not, and get the stems out. So back to the coloring. I stamped everything on white cardstock using jet black ink. I used the coordinating dice to cut them all and used my alcohol markers to color on the images. When the coloring was done, I took the main panel and taped the arrow handle using washi tape at the back. And I used one of my favorite supply. I used it quite often. It's the Cloudy Stencil along with Tumble Glass Distress Ink to create a pretty sky. You know me, I never leave a background without adding texture, so first I splattered water drops on my panel that I dried using a paper towel. And to bring a little bit of contrast, I simply mixed my Salty Ocean Distress Ink with water in order to create tiny drops. Next, my scene takes place in the countryside, so I needed grass borders. I cut two of those and colored them using distress inks, shabby shutters all over the border first, and then a little bit of peeled paint on the grass sprigs. Next, I smooshed the same inks onto my glass surface and I added water, and I used a very thin brush to create splatters on the border. And of course, I did the same thing on the second border. Next, I moved on to the magical wreath, and I first started by cutting all the pieces, 3 rings, 3 sausage pieces, 3 stabilizers, and 2 tabs, all using Strathmore Bristol cardstock. I took one of the rings and used the flux capacitor die to create 3 holes and 3 stitch brackets on that ring. And I put each sausage element into a hole, making sure to align everything with the inside curve of the ring. I used washi tape to keep everything together. So I did this for the 3 sausages, and next I applied 1 glue dot on each X mark on the rounded side of the sausages. And I used my small pointy tool to apply those glue dots more easily. Next, I took a second ring and lined it up over the sausage elements. I pressed firmly to seal the pieces and I removed the washi tape to this time keep the first and second rings in place. I turned the ring over and applied double-sided tape on the stitch bracket spots from the inside of the ring to the outside. I removed the backing paper and attached the 3 stabilizers on those bracket spots. I turned the ring over to have the front of it facing up and I stuck both tabs together. Usually you only need 1 tab, but I think that adding a second one makes the whole thing more sturdy. Next, I applied double-sided tape on 1/2 of the tab and attached it at the right of one of the stabilizers. I aligned it with the inside curve of the ring and created like a V shape with the stabilizer on the left. I applied double-sided tape on the 3 stabilizers, removed the backing papers, placed the last ring on top, and I folded the stabilizers on the ring to finish the magical wreath mechanism. Next, I applied liquid glue at the back of the arrow handle and I attached it on the tab. I made sure that it was aligned with the curve of the ring and I trimmed off the excess. Like my lemon pie card I shared a few weeks ago, I wanted to create clouds on the iris. So I taped the magic iris on my glass surface. I placed the cloudy panel with the stencil on top. I made sure that the clouds would coordinate and I used tumble glass distress ink again to create those matching clouds on the iris. I repeated the process until the iris was entirely covered and off screen I added the same texture as the main panel. I applied double-sided tape on the front of the ring. I also added a little bit of liquid glue to cover the whole element. I removed the backing papers and lined up the main panel on top to stick everything together. And next, I attached the grass borders using double-sided tape. Off screen, I cut another ring using the main panel die. I created clouds on that circle using the same technique as the one I used for the iris. And next I stamped my sentiment, life's a picnic with you. And I have centered it a little bit because I knew that the largest grass border would cover the bottom of that circle. Next I cut a 5.5 by 4.25 inches sticky note card base and attached two panels on top. The yellow paper is from the Spring Fling 6x6 paper pack and the blue one is from the Perfectly Played Chill 6x6 paper pack. So I attached those papers and next I placed my Magic Iris panel on the card base. I applied liquid glue at the back of my sentiment circle and I tucked that circle right in the middle, trying to line up the clouds as nicely as possible. Finally, I applied foam tape at the back of the Magic Iris panel and I stuck it in place on the card base. I opened and closed the iris a few times just to make sure that it was working well. And then I attached the images using glue dots mostly, but also foam squares to bring dimension on some parts of the scene. At this point, I wanted those flowers to be looking at the opposite direction, so I started by cutting their heads off. I turned the stems and attached the heads on the opposite side. And next I kept going and stuck the remaining images. When everything was attached, I added white highlights on the images. And finally, I added a yellow arrow on the handle to match the pretty yellow paper on the card base. And that's it. This is the final result. The mice parents thought that they could chill and have some quiet time, but it looks like a cute ant family is about to steal their lunch. But I'm sure that it turned out okay and that everyone shared the food. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!